MLB The Show has baseball from the Lone Star State as we get a look inside Globe Life Field. We've got an AL Western Division showdown tonight between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Texas Rangers. It's baseball. It's The Show, and it comes your way next.
Rangers.
Rick Slade, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
Now at the plate, here is Steele Walker. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Rangers, the center fielder, Steele Walker.
From the stretch. Here's the 0-1. And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss.
Hey, nobody out.
Hey, great job by the offense right here to put a number up on the board and allow this young gun to go out on the mound, relax a little bit, and establish that good fastball.
The 1-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout.
Flat out locked him up with a changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two-strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
Batting second, the second baseman.
Into the box now, Zach McKinstry, as he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. So, fellas, this Angels team entering play here tonight, they've got to be considered one of, if not the hottest team in baseball right now. Winners of 8 of their last 10 ball games.
Yeah, Matty, this team has been playing really well right now. And this is case in point. Chance to jump out again to another 1-0 lead. They've really been doing that. They've been on attack, early offensive, almost ambush-like approaches to their at-bats, and it's working for them.
Well, time to look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Dave Lawrence.
Dan, we got Dave Lawrence behind the dish tonight. One of the best in the business, in my opinion, but sometimes has a tendency to fall into a pattern where he's given a little bit too much on that outside corner.
Yeah, D-Row, one of the things he'll do, he'll open up that outside corner, especially with left-handed batters.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Fouled off. The next 1-2 pitch looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
The main job of the number 1 and 2 hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
Batting third.
And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder David Dahl as he takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1.
Two out.
Ball one.
Gonna be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
The 1-1.
His offense gave him an early lead, and he is on the attack. Punched out the first two guys and made it look easy, and still getting ahead.
And it's fouled away.
Hey, this guy's dialed in right now. Two strikeouts and still working ahead. This is going to be a tough test for the offense.
Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. They trail this one 1-0. here's the former prize Dodger prospect, Willie Calhoun. And he's looking to snap out of what's been a rather dry spell at the plate. He's set, and the pitch taken, and that one catches the bottom part of the strike zone. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Now the 0-2 pitch.
He didn't look overly fooled right there, because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
And it lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
So he froze him for the strikeout. Willie Calhoun is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning.
The first base.
Here comes Christian Walker. Is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
Behind 0-2 now. Angels lead at 1-0 here in inning number two. A bouncer to the left side, scooped up, and there's out number two. Brendan Rodgers bats next, and he's looking to turn things around. Ice cold at the plate in recent action, and he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing and one. Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2.
Down 0-2 to a guy with this much weaponry, five pitches he can go to, not looking good.
And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Rangers set down in order. They still trail 1-0. So now here is Zach Collins. He's hitting in the 270s on the season coming into this one. Changeup, it's 1-0.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
The throw into second, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Man, that swing looked like self-defense than a real quality swing, but hey, he muscled it out there, and it was enough to get him safely to second. Those are the kind of hits that will drive you nuts as a pitcher.
Shurton Apostle swings and misses there, so he's down 0-1. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Hey, two pitches at the knees right now, and you're down 0-2. This is where you got to fight. I want to see a two-strike approach. Maybe a little choke-up, maybe a little fight up the middle the other way. Grind back into this count.
So he got him swinging. Shurton Apostle is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning.
Batting ninth, the designated hitter.
Into the box, Gabriel Arias. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Count now a ball and a strike. Sent on the ground out to second, and that's through, a base hit, the throw home, but this won't be in time as he's well safe and the run scores. Next to dig in, Steele Walker. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one.
Hey, this pitcher's going to have to step off the mound right here and refocus. Take a deep breath, something. Can't keep falling behind and creating traffic. It puts everybody on edge, not only himself, his defense, and especially his manager.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Arias stands at first with one out. Pulled toward right center field. Heading after it is Kepler. And he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you can see there, he's part of a flat-footed tie for the AL lead. Lifted down the line in left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. And he fouls this one off. Two out with the man at first. Change up, and he ain't buying it. 1-2.
I love a well-executed changeup, especially one down in the zone. The only problem throwing it in that situation, you leave.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Gotta love a night at the ballpark. These fans. And now, David Dahl struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
That evens it up, 1-1. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss as he ran that in on him. A ball and two strikes.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Here now the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Always tough for one of these base umpires to make a call on a guy's check swing. It's not a great angle, and everything happens so quickly, so they really have to be paying attention out there. Looking at the replay, I think he got it right, so that's a tip of the cap for the Blue.
Willie Calhoun comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Swinging a ball hit on the ground.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting a good pitch to hit are way worse.
So it was a swinging strike three. Willie Calhoun becomes out number two this inning. First pitch of the AB on its way. Christian Walker is at the plate as he watches ball one. That missed close. It's ball two.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters' counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in the zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. Fouled away. You out here? A bouncer to the left side. Reined in over to first, and that retires the side. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. On to the top of inning number five we go. It's the Angels 2 and the Rangers 1. So now into the box is Brendan Rodgers.
For the Rangers, the shortstop, Brendan.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. That one catches the edge of the zone, called a strike. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Yeah, this is straight survival mode. Down 0-2, the numbers are definitely not with the batter here.
Looking to punch him out again. Pitch.
Count 1-2.
Now a swing and a fly ball. And foul. He'll try again, 1-2. Fouled off. And he struck him out. The 10th victim set down on strikes thus far. So yet another strong outing for him tonight as we show you the league leaders in ERA. And as you can see, he currently ranks second in the AL in that department. So here is Zach Collins. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at bat. A ball and no strikes. One run, two hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. Swung on and missed. Yep, one and one. Come on, guys. And this will be fouled away. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ball game.
Man, this guy's on his game today, not only when he's throwing strikes, but how about the amount of strikeouts? What's even more impressive, no walks up to this point. So he's pounding that zone with strikes, and he's making these hitters swing the bat.
At the plate, Sherton Apostle. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Count even now at 1-1.
Two down here.
Here's the pitch. Ball just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
Two balls, one strike.
To 2-2 now. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score.
All right, come on now.
And it's fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Down the first baseline. Fielded cleanly. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Nothing doing here this half. Five innings complete. Angels are out in front, 2-1. Digging in will be Gabriel Arias. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, let's see if he can work a walk, maybe a knock, ground ball with eyes, something. Catch a gap to get this offense going. Two hits as a team can start demoralizing your confidence. But if he can get on and start some traffic in motion, we might have something.
And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. Hard hit ball to second. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And a good try to recover that time, but he'll beat it out as he's aboard to kick off the inning. Next to hit is Steele Walker. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First pitch of the AB now. Strike taken as the curveball drops into the bottom part of the zone.
Oh, that pitch tells me this guy's feeling frisky right now. He's on. He's got everything working.
A great job of changing speeds there. It's 0-2. And that one yanked just foul. Low scoring game thus far. 2-1 here in the sixth. And this will be fouled away. He's just rolling right now, and even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there. Well, these guys haven't had too many opportunities yet to test the running game in this one, so they could decide to put a man in motion right here.
A ground ball to third, and they could get two. To second for one. On to first, it's a double play. As their woes continue, the inning is over. That's how you roll it. 5-4. David Dahl to the plate now. He'll be the man to lead things off here in the bottom of the seventh.
Offense just needs to find a way to get that pass the baton mentality. Starts one at bat at a time. I know they need base runners clearly. Maybe if they could get a few guys on the pillow, someone can bop one and get them back in this.
Curveball looked at here for strike one.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in an 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the break. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
A couple of strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at-bat trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
Bases are empty, one man out. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. Now a breaking ball, but it's low.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Another full count pitch home.
Hey, we got one here.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball.
Hey, this is a heck of a battle right here. Long AB. You know what? They find themselves still facing a starter. If they would have had some ABs like this earlier in the game, I think they get into the bullpen by this time.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Willie Calhoun becomes the second out of the bottom of the seventh.
Now batting, the first baseman.
So now to the plate, Christian Walker, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Boy, he looks strong out there on the mound this inning. He's got a chance to punch out the side in order and against the middle of the order, too.
And he's got another one. 15 strikeouts in the ball game, and the side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. Eighth inning coming up. The Halos lead this one 7-1. Ty Buttrey is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 31.
On paper, this had the makings of a real hard-fought game, but paper and reality, those are two different things. They pulled away and never looked back. How about to a tune of a 9-run victory?
10-1, the final lopsided score in this ball game. The Halos put a 10 spot on the scoreboard in this one. Chris Sellers earns a league-leading 11th win of the year with 15 strikeouts. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. Now from the home of the Rangers, we're at Globe Life Field in Arlington. Tonight, it's an in-division matchup from the AL West between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Texas Rangers. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next.
24, Texas Rangers.
JT Brubaker, a righty from the state of Ohio, will do the pitching in this one. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
One of the things that jumps out, if you look at that stat sheet, a very high whip coming into this start. One of the things he's going to have to do a much better job, keep traffic off the bases, keep the walks down, try to limit the amount of hits. He's had a rough go of that so far this year. Let's see if he can turn it around in this one.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Hammered the other way to deep right field. Racing back the right fielder. And that one is gone. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. 24 home runs for him on the season. And the Angels are now out to a 2-0 lead.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that
ready to take his hacks again. Chris Sellers blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Hit high and deep to right center. Long run for the center fielder. but it's over his head and it hops the wall for a ground rule double.
There's a deep fly ball. Doesn't quite get out of the ballpark, but it hits in the right spot as it bounces off that hard warning track and over the wall for a ground rule double. Not sure if he had triple on his mind, but I doubt he'll complain too much about getting to coast into second base.
He's got it. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. And now the designated hitter for the Angels, Chris Sellers. He'll lead things off as they look to perhaps build on an already sizable lead. Here's the first pitch. Hard liner to center field. Walker is right there, one down. Next to stand in is Chris Sellers. Two RBIs already, looking for more here. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. High in the air out to center field. And this will be taken in without much trouble. It's an easy start to the seventh. Two gone.
Four wins in a row for these guys, and I'm sure they're feeling pretty good about themselves. We'll see how long they can keep this up.
A tight one, 7-6, the final score tonight. The Los Angeles Angels with a division-leading 60th team win this year. Griffin Canning hangs win number 11 on his line. JT Brubaker was hit hard to the tune of 7 earned as he takes the loss. Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. We've got baseball on the 4th of July between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Texas Rangers.
And now, your 2001
live baseball. Joe Ross is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Rangers. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, this guy's done a real good job on the year keeping the opponent's batting average down. Both righties and lefties coming into this one, hitting under 250 against this guy. He's been good all season long.
Sent on the ground out to second. And he's set down, one away. Stepping up is Chris Sellers. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Walker has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first down. So with one away, a couple of teams out of the AL West doing better. Now to the plate, here is Chris Sellers, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. First pitch of the AB on its way. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that will end up a foul ball. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Three runs already home here. Swung on, and this ball is hammered. Forget about it. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. So it's a two-run shot to right center, number 25 for him on the year, and the lead is now 7-2.
I know hindsight's 20-20, but you can't throw that pitch to that guy. Don't forget, he homered yesterday, so you know he's locked in and ready to roll up there. We'll see if he learns from that mistake.
Next, it'll be Zach Collins. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Grounded up the first baseline. A dive, but it's off his glove. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. think a few of these folks need to get out of the sun. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. second, and that's through into right field for a base hit. And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out.
Boy, Dero, we're looking at a big inning right here with that single. Bases are loaded, yet no runs have scored in this inning.
Yeah, and that's exactly what that pitcher wants you to think. You have to eliminate the noise, Dan. Just try and drive in the guy from third base. Don't put pressure on yourself that you have to get everyone in with one swing of the bat. Pass the baton and keep the line moving.
Next up for the Stros, Corey Lee. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Bounce to first, right to him, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Chris Sellers, singled in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, pressure's off right now. He extended his hitting streak that last plate appearance. Now he gets to get back into his zone, work on his craft, and try and drive something in the gap.
And that's in for a base hit. He's 2-for-4 now. So make it 2 hits for him now on the night as this one finds its way into center. And as you can see there on the team leaderboard, he's currently tops on the ball club in that department as we approach the All-Star break. And digging in next will be Anthony Rendon. A couple of walks for him thus far. Throw over to first, and he'll get back in safely. To one, here it is. Pitch inside, the throw, and he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Trying to move into scoring position with two away, but not to be as we get another look. Next up, Carlos Correa, 0-for-2 for him to this point. The 0-1 pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Ah, way to get dirty. Got him. Three thumbs up here in the booth following this gorgeous play at second base. So now to the plate, Chris Sellers. He's got 2 hits in 4 at-bats. He's set. Here it comes. Hard hit ball to short. Scooped up. He'll go to Scope at second for the force out, and that ends the inning. Angels leave one. They're still out in front, 5-2.
You can just see that the confidence is radiating off of them out there right now. That's 6 wins in a row, and this looks like a train that's not about to slow down anytime soon.
And this evening's ends at a 7-2 finish. Back here on the MLB pregame show, first pitch just a few moments away as Dan Plesac and I get you ready for baseball under the lights with the Topps Player Spotlight. Chris Sellers. Okay, we're looking forward to this one. Lineups and first pitch on MLB Network are right around the corner. We'll be back right after this. Downtown Houston, Texas on a Saturday night in Minute Maid Park. Tonight, game 2 of this 3-game weekend series between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Houston Astros. Jose Urquidy, the right-hander from Mexico, gets the ball here. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Wow, when you look into the numbers, they can be a little bit deceiving. Normally, most pitchers pitch better at home, but not this guy. He actually prefers and pitches better on the road. We'll see how he does and if he can adapt and start pitching better at home in this one.
Hit in the air down the right field line, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. The windup and the 0-1. Hard ground ball to third. Bregman gloves it. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Angels go down 1-2-3. They're down 2-0. And now for the Angels, Chris Sellers. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
On to first, and they get them both. Into the box, Chris Sellers. We're in the eighth now, and nothing's changed out there on the mound.
Nah, they just haven't had much of an answer, Matty. They've been off balance and baffled all game. He's got a nice, comfortable lead. You have to think he's going to pound the strike zone. But here, get aggressive.
And into center field, a base hit. So early trouble here to start the eighth inning. Cutting it close here, but he comes through in the eighth to extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he was staring at his last at-bat right there, probably his last at-bat. Would have been tough to get him another AB in this one, but he's able to get it done.
Hey, better late than never, and I'm sure when he walked into that batter's box right there, he's thinking, this very well could be my last AB of this game, so if I'm going to keep this streak alive, going to have to do it right now.
7-1, the final score in tonight's. The Astros jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Jose Urquidy with his fourth win this season, turning in a very strong complete game effort. Noah Syndergaard worked only three innings in the losing effort. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac.